If there is a guy who wears a pure white coat, has a high social class, and makes a lot of money, do you admire him? I can't hear you.
Yes!
Okay, let me tell you some stories of so-called doctors. Personally, I'm a 180cm doctor. I remember, when I was in the medical school, I went to the hospital to be a... I remember, the first day, I wore my brand new white coat, stand inside the hospital. I swore to God, I would become the greatest doctor, cure many patients, save many lives, and date all the beautiful girls in that. However, as time goes by, there were old doctors, young doctors, old nurses, young, pretty charming nurses, walking by me. Nobody ever paid attention to me, like I was invisible. How can they treat a great doctor like this? Suddenly, a doctor in long robe with gray hair and a serious face came and said, "Are you my cook?" Well, he seemed to be somebody, so I replied with respect, "Yes, sir." "Okay, come with me." Then he put an x-ray film on the whiteboard. "What's this?" "Well, it looks like an x-ray film." "I know it's an x-ray film. I'm asking you, what's the patient's problem?" "Problem? Yeah, sure. Well, it looks like there's some problems with the chest." "Of course there's some problems with the chest, you idiot." "What's this? What's this?" "Oh, this. Well, it looks like the heart." "Heart, you know. You broke my heart." "Your heart. On the right side? It's a cancer. How can I teach a stupid cook like you?" Then he just laughed. I stood there, with tears swelling inside my eyes. I realized cooks were just the most humble people in the hospital. And our job was to please the senior doctors. After the invisible life of Kirk's, I grew up and became an intern doctor. An intern doctor can prescribe some simple medications and perform some simple procedures. So, I was thinking, aha! It's my turn to be the boss! This time, my patients will respect me and the nurses will worship me. When I was excited and imagining the romance that is going to happen, suddenly, a miracle happened. A young nurse was the beautiful nurse in the hospital. The flower of the hospital. At that time, I was sure I heard something. Oh no, it was my heartbeat. I tried to stay calm. A great doctor can't be nervous. She stood in front of me and smiled at me. Then she threw something on the desk. At first, I thought it was a love letter. But it seemed too big and too thick. Unless she had so many things she would like to tell me. Well, nah, it's just a chart. The medical record of a patient. She said, "Queen 13, unless a headache, she wants to see a doctor." She didn't even call my name. Was she too shy of something? After 10 minutes, I found I was totally wrong. Because after then, more than 10 nurses came to me and did exactly the same thing. "Doctor, room 6 wants to see you. Doctor, room 12 wants to see you." I realized, intern doctors were just the cheap laborers in the hospital who worked for more than 70 hours a week and got a little more than $10,000 a month. You do the math. After I finished the 7 years of medical school. I became a resident doctor. A resident has to live in the hospital. Whenever the patient needs us, no matter how sleepy we are, we have to get up and solve their problems. One night, while I was sleeping, a nurse woke me up. Get up, get up, get up. I was unhappy, but I knew a patient must be. So I grabbed the chart and rushed to the patient. Sir, how can I help you? The man seemed a little confused, and he said, well, it's okay. It's just I have some trouble sleeping, and you just woke me up. But the nurse told me you have a chest pain. No, I don't have any chest pain. Really? you are going to have an open heart surgery tomorrow. It's very common to be nervous. Wait, I'm just here for general examination. What open heart surgery? At the time, the nurse came in and she yelled, Dr. Chen, what are you doing here? Room 6 is next door. Then I went out the door as best as I could. I realized, to be a great doctor, there are a lot of embarrassing lessons you have to learn. Now, after these true stories, do you still admire those who wear white coats? Actually, I don't regret it, because I know curing patients is never easy, and I will try my best in the future to fulfill my dream to be a great doctor. And that's it.